He had this famous pyramid of success, and it was built on all these great virtues.
He wanted to put those values into his basketball team. And he made every one of them study that pyramid of success. And it became famous at UCLA.
Enthusiasm.
Confidence.
Self-control.
Conditioning.
Loyalty.
Competitive greatness.
All the personal characteristics that he preached to us that we would need in our life to be eventually successful. That's what the pyramid is all about.
For him, it was not necessarily wins and losses, but how he affected young men's lives.
Success is a result of satisfaction from knowing you made the effort to do the best of what you're capable.
And they're mobbing Johnny Wooden as he bows out with an NCAA championship.
The best coaching record in the history of basketball. 10 national championships in 12 years. 88-game winning streak. And maybe the best of all that no one talks about, 38 in a row in the tournament.
He was so detailed that the first day of practice, he literally showed you, gentlemen, this is how we put our socks on. You know, we make sure there's no wrinkles.
He'd start by showing you how to lace up your shoes
and to lace them up and tie them properly.
He knew to the precise second where we were supposed to be on the court and what he wanted to do instructionally.
Wooden was so basic in everything he did. You could break down film and you knew exactly what they were going to do, but you just couldn't stop.
He preached this pious line of it not really being important to win, but rather simply to get the best out of what you could be. But at the same time, this was a man who was very impatient with losing.
You had undoubtedly twice as many turnovers, and we should be the other way around.
There's this perception of John Wooden that he is this saint-like creature and so calm, so reserved. But there's also the side of Coach Wooden that he is this cage tiger.
Bill, how many times was I talking about throwing that ball down the middle?
He could make a player cry with the things he said, and he never swore.
Coach's way of swearing, of course, was to say, goodness gracious sakes alive.
Gracious sakes alive!
When he said, gracious sakes alive, I mean, the hairs on your neck stood up. You knew you were in big trouble.
He can't be St. Francis of Assisi sitting here on the sidelines. He's really General Patton.
He has the image of the parson, but he had that rolled-up program, and he would talk to the opposing players through that rolled-up program.
There's a guy from Duke, Bob Verga, who was an All-American. As soon as Verga would come close to him, Lucius Allen's going to eat you up tonight. You haven't seen anybody as quick as Lucius Allen. I can't wait to get him on you. Bob Verga's going, he said, is that Coach Wooden talking to me?
In 27 years, Wooden's coaching philosophy established a basketball dynasty at UCLA, but it's his impact off the court that resonates far beyond any title.
I carry around Coach Wooden's pyramid of success in my wallet, and every time I'm struggling, every time I'm having difficulty, I just pop it open and take a look and review, because that is a foundation for success and happiness in life.
He is a guy that I think, as a player, I appreciated, you know, 100-fold more after 15, 20 years after I left the program.
The greatest tool that a teacher can have is love. And we saw it in Pauley Pavilion every single day. He never took the credit for our successes. He always said it was us and never said it was him.